Hello guys. You are on the channel Alice Reddit Stories. Enjoy watching. Story 1. OOP, I saw my husband and my sister naked in my kitchen. I can't move. If I move, it becomes real, and I have to accept what I saw and think of what's next. I came home from work early and saw my sister's car, thinking maybe she was dropping off some food from her job. But no, I walk in and see my husband and sister naked in my kitchen. The kitchen I paid for. As soon as I registered what I saw, I got into my car and left. I kept driving, just driving, driving, driving until I found the hotel I'm at now. I don't want to believe it. I don't know what to do. My sister, my only family, and my best friend, the one who's supposed to be there for me and support me. My husband, my person, my other half, the one who's supposed to love and respect me. The two most important people in my life have ruined everything. I've blocked them both on my phone. I don't want to hear any of the bullshit excuses they'll come up. I don't want to confront this. I want to go back to this morning when everything was fine. Update: I saw my husband and my sister naked in my kitchen. Sorry for not replying to comments and not updating. Things have been hectic. I didn't think I needed to explicitly say this, but by naked I meant they were butt naked and fucking in the kitchen. I admit mentioning that I paid for the kitchen was odd and kinda funny. But anyone that knows me knows that the kitchen is my pride and joy, so yes, when I saw my sister and husband fucking in my kitchen, it stuck with me. And yes, they did see me. When I got to the hotel, I cried for a few hours, and then I just wanted to tell someone, anyone. The two people I would talk to when something happened in my life were the two I needed to talk about, and it was 11 something in the evening, so I wasn't going to disrupt my friends' evenings and burden them. So instead, I came to Reddit thinking not many would see it. The response I received was overwhelming. I want to say thank you to everyone that sent me kind words and advice. Thank you so much for all the virtual hugs. I know I only commented once, it's because I had so much to think about and do. I appreciate all the love and support. There was so much amazing advice given in the comments. Although a lot of it was American-based, I still appreciate it. But one thing I did see a lot was to unblock them and keep the texts and calls as evidence, so I did do that. After posting and another good cry, I knew that I had to get my shit together. I didn't have my sister or any family to help, so I had to do it myself. I started researching what my next steps were. In the morning, my friend called me saying my sister contacted her wondering if I had been in contact with her. I told her what happened, and she very kindly offered her spare room and her day off work to help me sort stuff out. I called in sick at my job, and my friend helped get things done. I got in contact with my friend who works at a bank, and she helped me start sorting my financials. My friend also found me a lawyer to consult with. After my phone consultation with the lawyer, I was so overwhelmed. I now know why so many women don't divorce their cheating husbands. I, fortunately, make a stable income and can support myself, and we, fortunately, don't have kids. I have to remember that things aren't going to happen in one day. As for the house, unfortunately, his parents did buy it for us, and to be honest, after what I saw, I don't want it. I will try to get reimbursed for my beloved kitchen, otherwise, it can burn for all I care. This has been super draining, but I knew I had to talk to them. I already knew there was no coming back for my husband, and when I checked his messages, they were exactly what I thought they would say. I'm sorry. It's not what it looks like. We didn't mean for it to happen. Please come home. I love you. Blah blah blah. Just absolute bullshit. A small part of me thought maybe I could find it in me to forgive my sister, as we only have each other. But after I opened her messages, all hope was lost. She used the same excuses we heard our father use when he cheated on our mother and beat us. She said the same things our mother would say when she would excuse our dad's behavior and also beat us. I spoke to her this morning and asked her to tell me straight up who, what, where, when, and why. She told me back in July when I went on a girls' trip she was at our house and joked to my husband that I would cheat on him on the girls' trip because that's what always happens. He said nah, and they joked about it, but she said he could get even with me, and they ended up doing it once. One time lead to 2 to 3 then, to whenever they could do it. There was never any evidence or signs or anything that I was going to or even thinking of cheating. I told her we were done and there is nothing she could do to bring us back together. I later received a call from an unknown number. It was my mother, who I haven't spoken to in 7 years. Turns out my sister has been in contact with her and told her what had happened, and my POS mother, the same woman who beat me for breathing wrong, had the audacity to say this is what I get for taking her daughters away from her. It hurts so much. I know things are going to get messier and this is going to be a long few years. I've now lost all my blood relations. I need to get all my shit and find a new place. I want to show them that I can and I will thrive without them. Again, thank you all from the bottom of my heart for all the love and advice. All the people in the comments that could relate to me, I'm so sorry. Story 2. My wife is really sick, like really sick, but she's cheating on me, again. I don't know what to do. Long post and I'm only hitting high level. Also not trying to act like I'm a fucking gift. TLDR, wife is scary level sick, but I just found the third round of dick pics on her phone and intimate conversation. Her phone is her business, I respect her privacy, but I'm 3/3 in finding exactly what I hoped not to find. Keeping it somewhat vague because my, late 30s M, wife, late 30s F, of plus 10 years is a Redditor. Our relationship hasn't been the greatest for a while, almost feels like cohabitating at this point, but she's always had something medical or mental going on that has made me terrified to leave. I'd be a bad person to leave. 0.5 or so years ago, she began getting really close to a friend, ex-boyfriend from a while ago, and reconnecting. I knew this person from childhood, and she didn't have much support from people other than me, so I didn't pay it much mind. But she started getting defensive, acting weird, short fuse and the like. I snooped, which is shitty, but I found what I suspected, correspondence on her phone that is great and not cool. Pics of this dude's weird-looking dick and phone sex type shit. I confronted her about it and gave her the benefit of the doubt. The relationship stopped then and there. This wouldn't happen again, right? It couldn't. Plus, I could always be a better husband, so maybe I was being inadequate. Fast forward to 2 years or so, and she got into online gaming. Again, cool, interacting with people and communicating with real people. That's a plus and potentially good for her mental well-being. Then the game took over her life, playing all day every day and living every moment with a core group of friends. I always noticed she had a lot of men she was close with. But I trust her, they're just talking about the game and strategizing, and maybe a lot of men plays this game. Who am I to intervene? Noticed the same symptoms as before, sticking up for her friends' problems, conversations with her game friends getting more personal, helping people through tough times. Even asked me to help make a playlist for one of her friends who was going through a rough patch. I was kind of sketched out, but whatever, the guy was having a rough go of it and maybe I could help. But I couldn't bring myself to make anything because it just felt weird. There was something about this online relationship. I snooped again and unfortunately proved myself right, intimate conversations, discussions of what it would be like to be together, and the icing on the shit sandwich was a dick pic of two. Her responses to this pic were not of disgust or surprise or hey asshole I'm married fuck off, she engaged. Confronted her about this cheating, yes, this is cheating for me especially because I've respected our relationship. I did some dumb shit way back when before we were engaged or married, but I made a stupid mistake in college and would never do that to her again. She played it down as best as she could and as far as I'm concerned, skirted an apology. Once again, she's sick, what am I to do? I asked her to stop talking to this person, but she said she had to for the game as he was a leader alongside her. But the conversations were only about the game and for the benefit of their team. I didn't buy it, but I trust her. I married her. It's weird, but I guess that's life now. Relationship continued to stagnate, and I told myself I'd give it a year to get better. She's just not okay mentally, and I must not be doing something right, or I could be a better husband. We'd get through this. I'd also quit drinking, which was a win, so now I could be more present. I picked up weed a bit to fill the gap. Sometimes I just wanted to shut off mentally, and that was helping. Well, we're up on a year, and things are better than before in some ways because we actually talk a bit more and get out and about, but I'm far from happy, but maybe we can be. That said, the talking is because I've been home a lot to take care of her with a no-bullshit life-threatening disease. Getting out and about constitutes going to doctor's appointments, which at this point are nearly 2x per week. But we have fun together going to these, people watching, talking shit, listening to music, picking up food from our favorite restaurants. But, once again, acting differently, and I notice her texting more than I've ever seen. One is a close friend through her game that is just that, a friend. Great. But I couldn't help but seeing the initials of the most recent dick picker in her subject for text messages. Must be talking about the game a lot. This brings us to Tuesday. We're at the hospital for a procedure, everything is great. She asks me to get her phone and send a message to one of her friends, the one from the game I'm cool with. When I go to send it, I see those initials of Dick Picker just below in the list of recent texts. I snoop, third time ever, and there it is, Dick Pick with some bullshit comment I can't remember. Wife's response, you ask? One of these zippermouth face. I close the phone and give it to her. I say nothing. Am I going to pick a fight in the hospital? Fuck no. Am I going to get home and mention it so we can argue while she needs to keep her mental strength and recover? That feels wrong. So here I sit. That's all I got. I probably deserved some of it, like I said, I must have driven her to this somehow. But it sucks. And I think it's going to continue to suck. At this point, I just need her to get better and survive this shit. But fuck, it sucks. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. There are many interesting stories ahead of you.